Since the dawn of time, a skateboard has been a plank of wood connected to wheels by metal trucks. How far could technology push that before it doesn't even count as skateboarding anymore? Viewer of the channel Jurgen asked the question, how far could skateboard technology go before it doesn't even count as skateboarding anymore? He submitted his question by going to radradvideo.com. You can do that as well. I want to look at a couple of theoretical inventions to see if they push it too far. And the first one is spring-powered ollies. So imagine if your trucks had springs in them, and as you popped, it pushed you up in the air and you got a little bit higher. Is this even possible? I think so. So here are Avenue trucks. If you haven't seen these before, these are essentially one big spring. They are there for the purpose of absorbing impact, like the suspension on your car. But look at the claim they make on their website. We are the only skate truck that helps add pop. Our base plates compress slightly before every ollie. Once you pop, that preloaded compression is immediately released and force is expelled upwards into the deck. Let's take that claim at face value and assume that it does actually work like that. I'm assuming with their trucks, it's a microscopic difference at all, but let's take it to its extreme. Let's imagine that your trucks have multiple springs in it. Maybe it can detect the second you pop and it can launch you up in the air and you get an extra foot every time you pop the tail. Would that be cheating? To me, it kind of depends on a couple of things. First of all, are there rules in skateboarding that applies to all of these? And, you know, I generally think no, but at the same time, somebody doing something that makes everything a lot easier does still feel like cheating. The other part is, what are you doing with them? Are you skating something that couldn't be skated without them? So imagine if you bring a kicker with you to a street spot. It makes sense to do if that spot cannot be skated without the kicker, but if you bring a kicker to a ledge that's an inch higher and you just want to save yourself the effort of, you know, getting a foot of pop, then you would probably consider that cheating. So I think it would probably work that same way. If you're just casually skating a 8-inch high ledge, but you have these spring trucks to make it really easy, that would probably be considered cheating, but it would feel really cool. Next is motorized wheels. Now I know that motorized longboards do exist, but let's imagine that there's no big battery pack that makes it harder to do tricks, and also they can detect which way you're moving. So if you do a pop shove it, the wheels will keep going the direction you're going. They will turn around in the air and keep going. And if you could do that, it seems like it would be pretty cool. Because if you see someone being towed by a bike or a car, you know, like to go up to this big ramp and do something crazy, you assume it's about to be something really cool. So if you could use these wheels to go really fast, that would be a good thing. And that would be true if you're doing a really fast line. You know, imagine you do a nice long grind, you land, it just speeds you back up, you do your next trick, carve over here, it keeps your speed going, and then you do your last trick and you didn't have to push the whole time. In that case, I think it would be kind of cool because you never worry about whether the skater could have pushed that hard to do the trick. It doesn't really matter. It just matters that he did the trick, right? But there is some room for cheating in this, and I think the way that I would use it would probably definitely be cheating. So imagine if instead of having it set to really fast, you had it set to pretty slow. Now if you do that backside flip where your toe touches and you didn't spin the whole way, you would still land going the same speed that you started from, and it would make it a lot easier to pass for looking like a legitimate trick. Or imagine you do a slide until you're completely stopped, you could still land and roll away with some speed, which would also make that look a little bit more like a legitimate trick. And in that case, I think that would also be cheating. The next is motorized truck rollers, and this one might take a little bit of imagination. If you've seen someone skate a box completely stationary, like the tramp skate guy comes to mind. He skates on a trampoline for the most part, but he also does some clips of him skating stationary and doing like grinds on a rail and things like that. Imagine if you could get into it and you had something like the Z rollers from back in the 1980s, where they had this free spinning part on the grind surface of the truck, where you could just have it roll and it wouldn't slow you down with actual grinding. But instead of that, it's powered. So you could get into a grind stationary and it could take off and actually like slide you along. I think unanimously this one would be considered cheating, but you could use it subtly, you know, like make a really long grind at high speed a little bit longer and a little bit faster. you could do that. Or you could have it hurt your speed. Like when Andy Anderson did that anti-wax thing to make that handrail grind slower so he could get around that kink. Like you could set it so you're going just slow enough to make it through something like that. That would be kind of cool, but that's not what people would do. They would use it to just do faster grinds. I think this one would also feel really cool. If you could get into a stall, you can turn it into a grind, and that would be pretty cool. But it is definitely cheating. The good thing about this is that I don't think it's possible. Because if they move, you know, going this way always, but you're in a Smith grind on a ledge, it seems like the truck would kind of pull you off of it. So I don't think we have to worry about this one being invented anytime soon. But if they do, that one would probably count as cheating. And the sound would be all messed up too. There's one more, but I want to thank Jürgen again for his question. You can submit them through redratvideo.com or through Patreon, where you will definitely get a direct answer from me. And you can also get early access to some kinds of series. Most of my gameplay ones go up in one big chunk on there if you want to check those out. But the last example that I have is gyroscopic flip support. And I think this one would be possible, at least from a physics perspective. But picture a three-axis gyroscope on the bottom of your board. You won't be able to do board slides, but what you could do is adjust all of your flip tricks. So imagine you're doing a kickflip, you flipped it a little bit off, you're about to land primo, it could speed up, push the board to flip that extra mount, and you can land it. Or you can set it to land primo on purpose mode, and Johnny Geiger could take all the difficulty out of his impossible tricks of Rodney Mullen series. But it would have a lot of different ways that you could use it. So imagine you did a 360 flip, you under rotated it but over flipped it. It can correct in the air, it can do a perfect 360 flip. As soon as you land, the thing would reset and be ready for the next trick. Or do a kickflip and it is rocketed. Well, no worries, it would flatten out the board, or you can dial in the stees amount in the app and it can be a little bit nosedive so you catch it looking extra cool. So it could do stuff like that, but it could be a little more subtle. So let's say you are doing a gap. You're about to land, you kickflipped a bunch of stairs, and you're gonna land a little bit sideways. It could straighten it out so that you land with all of your speed. And I think this one, I mean, it's obviously cheating. This one would definitely be cheating, but it could be pretty useful as a training device. So imagine if you're trying to learn a kickflip, you know, if you're like me, that took a while. It's a very hard thing to learn for the first time. Such a difficult, it's a big bite to take to learn the whole trick at once. But if you have this and you have your assistance turned all the way up to high, you learn the kickflip, it's kind of easy. Then you turn the assistance down, you kind of learn that next step. Like, oh wait, I wasn't flipping quite hard enough, let me do this. And then you turn it down, turn it down, turn it down. You've managed to learn to kickflip in smaller bites instead of doing it all at once. I think it would be very helpful for training, you know, and you're less likely to slam. Every time you try a 360 flip, you end up slamming on the ground and you skinned elbows and knees and stuff. Well, now you're landing it a lot more often and you still learn the actual trick at the end. I think it would be useful for that, and it would be fun. But aside from those things, it would definitely be cheating. But how about you? Can you imagine any skateboard inventions that would push the line a little bit too far and make it not really count as skateboarding and maybe count as cheating? Let me know about them in the comments.